dyed my hair when I was about 13. It was kind of just like a side thing, like a hobby. Like, I always had a passion for hair, but I just, like, started doing it. I never expected to turn into a job for me. Well, you know, me loving something that I do. Think the first time I did like some, I did my own first stuff. I did my own, the first time I did clothing, I did it on myself. I just would, you know, see the look and I was like, I think I can do that. So I was like, let me try it. So I did it on myself and then my friends started letting me do their hair. And so people were always asking me, like, who does your hair? And they would tell me, like, you should start doing hair. I'm like, no, I don't think I should start doing hair. Like, that's just a hobby, you know, I enjoy doing it, but I don't see myself making money doing it. So after I graduated high school, I had plans to go on to North Carolina Central University. I got accepted and everything, but I didn't know what I was going to major in. And I was just like, I'm just going, you know, my friends going to college, we want to get the experience, but I really didn't want to go there and waste my time or waste my money. So I ended up back in high school going, and I ended up going to enrolling in Nash Community College for cosmetology because I already knew how to do hair. But my first time enrolling in cosmetology was a fail. I just wasn't focused. I feel like it was pointless for me to go to school for something that I already knew how to do. So I ended up quitting and getting a quote-unquote real job, but I didn't like my job. I was still doing hair on the side. This was in 2012. My mom had got sick in 2009. That was another reason why I decided, you know, to stay around or whatever. She ended up passing in 2012, and before she passed, she used to always tell me, like, you know, you need to go back to school. That's something that you're really good at. And I was like, I really don't think I want to do hair for a living, though. So after she passed, you know, I thought about it, and I'm like, I kept going to different jobs, and I really wasn't enjoying them. So I was like, okay. My clientele was kind of building up. I was like, maybe I should go back to school. So I went back to school. And I had gained enough hours to get my natural hair care license. After I gained enough hours, I ended up finding out I was pregnant, which is in 2014. And I just got back to that stage where I wasn't motivated to, you know, keep going to school to finish out my whole cosmetology license. So I was like, well, I really enjoy doing sew-ins and braids, which is, you know, natural hair care, like protective styles and stuff. So really, I was like, well, I really don't need, you know, cosmetology school. I really need to go get a job, because like I said, I was expecting. So I ended up getting my natural hair care license, and I ended up becoming a customer service representative at AT&T phone company. And I kind of enjoyed that job, but I was still, you know, doing hair on the side and getting my clientele up. And so after I had my daughter, I hadn't looked into daycares or anything for her. So I was like, I'm not going back to work. I'm just going to step out of my faith and do hair. And my clientele was good enough for me to do that. That was back in 2014. I went into, my daughter was about 10 months. So in 2015, I went into my first salon, hair salon. Which I'm still there now. And I really, you know, I enjoyed being there. I enjoyed, you know, doing what I do. So after that, well, that's what I'm doing now. I'm working on having, right now I'm working on a wig line for patients and people that have hair loss, that suffer from hair loss. I'm hoping that I launch this wig line by October of 2018, just this year. It's going to be called Sweet Wig Collection. So I'm very, very excited about that. That's mainly my main focus right now. I plan to have my own shop, a one-stop shop. You can come and get, you know, everything done. Nails, hair, lashes, because we don't have things like that around here. Let me see. I did graduate from Tarver High.